Hello guys, and welcome back. If you remember, in our previous video, I have glued the second row of gun ports. As you can see, I also have sanded down the surfaces along the two gun port rows and made them flat, so they're ready for the planking. Here, with the sanding and at the other side, as you can see, I had a couple of pieces unglued a little at 1 millimeter or less, so I had to glue them back on. So this stays on until the glue is dry, but no worries, I'm going to work at the bow now. So what we have to do now is, first of all, cut these two excess pieces and then make this piece straight up to this level so I can place a prefixed small deck. So let me place the camera on a tripod and I'll get back to you to do that. Now, to cut these little two pieces of excess wood, I'm going to use a small saw. Remember that everything is going to be sanded down, and also it's going to be covered up, so don't worry about anything. Let me turn the ship around and do the same thing on the other side, because the ship would be facing the other way now, and it's hard to move the camera to show you the exact same procedure but at the other side. Now, as you can see, it's cut. It needs a little sanding, so I'm going to do that. I'm going to use this tool. It's flat, so that's why I'm going to use it, but because I'm right-handed, I'm going to do that exactly like I did the cut on the other side. So let me do that, no worth of filming it, and I'll get back to you. It's sanded down, it's smooth, it's flat, and I had finally to move the camera because I'm going to sand also these two pieces here. And it's better if you watch. And we must have the piece centered. To do that, I'm just going to measure the length and draw a line at the center. Also here, let's see where the center is. Definitely these pieces are centered, these gaps are centered. It's hard on camera, but I believe that they are at 6 centimeters. Yeah, so the center is here at 3. Let's have a 90 degree angle. I can definitely tell where the center is at this piece, so this is the center. Now, let me do that for this piece. That's the center. So there it is. That's dead center. Okay. Let me make some marks. Here are the hole. This piece is going to be later, after I planked it, is going to be opened up because, as you can see, it covers up the hole. So, but that's a lot late I'll much, much later. Okay. Let's use some cyanoacrylic glue. And on the inside where this piece unglued. After it's glued, we also need to do some sanding again. But that's easy. And the piece that was unglued is now glued. Now, let's do some sanding here. This piece, I don't know if you can see that. Maybe now you can see it. It's a little, maybe half a millimeter. Now, that's visible. This needs to be sanded down. So, let me do that. And I'll get back to you to do the next step. Now guys, the next step is to place the third row of gun ports and also the bulwarks. I believe it's called that. Bal or bulwarks. If anyone knows, please let me know. So, let me separate the pieces from the laser cut board and I'll get back to you to do the mounting. Let me show you something, guys, something that I just found out. I believe this is a mistake in the drawings, but a minor one and an easy to fix one. So, this is the third row. This, according to the plans, must match the lower row, the second row. Must go, it's hard to do that one hand, like this. You can see that over here has a small gap between, nothing to worry about. Like I said, everything is going to be covered, but as you can see here, I have a larger gap. Let's see if it, I cannot hold it. Now here there's a big gap, so as you can see, this piece is going to be held down only here at this point. That's hard because with some pressure it might go off and goes inside like this, and then we have a problem. And on the upper part it's okay. So what I need to do is place a small piece between to cover this gap. As you can see, it must be like a trigon. So, and at this width at the most. So let me improvise to do that and I'll get back to you. Now, as you can see, I've placed a little piece. I saved it, and now I have a beautiful fit. Now, let's see how this piece will glue. It will go like this. Here I have a gap. Nothing to worry about, that gap, like like I said, everything will be covered up. I can probably fix this gap. Sanding down just a little the corner. But I don't want to mess around with the height, because then maybe I have a problem with the height. This piece might be lower than the other. Okay, let me do some measurement and I'll get back to you. I have them on the same height, so I won't mess around with that. I'm going just to have this gap, and it will be covered up with wood strips. Now, let's clear the surface that I'm going to glue. This piece is very hard to glue. I have a small surface to stand, and I have to use cyanoacrylic glue, so it's very hard. I'm going to lay some cyanoacrylic glue on the inside, just to make the bond stronger. Now, what I'm going to do to make it even stronger is to use some white glue at the gap. And here is how I'm going to do it. Now, let me prepare to place the front piece. Now guys, just a small tip. You have to sand down this edge here. See how the edge is here. See how is the other one. So you can get a perfect fit, because here we have a curve. So let's do it again. This is the piece. As you can see, I have bent it just a little to match the curve of the bow. Now let's glue it. Big piece with very small surface, very hard to glue with cyanoacrylic. I have one side done, let me do the other and I'll get back to you. And done. Let me show you something, guys. Here you can see there's a small gap, also here there's a very small gap, but there's nothing to worry about, because at the interior of the bulwarks, don't know exactly how they're called, I'm going to place later on some wood strips, so everything will be covered up. Also, at this model, they are going to be painted red, so nothing to worry about. Now, I have to wait for the glue to dry. I have to cut these two excess pieces, sand them down, also do some sanding here and make everything to be an exact match and smooth, to be ready for the wood strips that are going to cover everything. And I believe we're done. So thanks again for watching, guys. As you can see, the ship is turning out to have a form right now, and it's already looking spectacular. So like I said, thank you very much for watching. See you soon with the next step.